Okay, this one's a guide to modifying or building your own printer. Because I've just modified and built my own printer, and it uses both 12 and 24 volt components in the same system, using two power supplies. Look, Ma, two power supplies. Let me tell you why that makes sense and how to do it on your own machine. So this is my Mendel 9000. This thing has been many printers before, including like the original Mendel 90, and I've had it kind of queued up to finish it up for a long time. But essentially, this is going to be my modular testing platform. Yeah, it looks kind of rough, but that's not the point. I've just grown tired of tearing apart perfectly good printers to test a new hot end or a different mainboard. You know, the problem isn't that the conversion to that new part would be hard, it's that the conversion back to stock is usually, well, impossible. So now I've got a whole bunch of machines that are permanently mutilated, and frankly, at this point, I'm running out of good stock printers that I can just use without them having some weirdness to them. So this one's built to be easily modifiable. It's got all standard connectors, it's using all these DuPont ones. It's got plenty of wiring, as you can see. The entire X carriage is just a grid of threaded M4 holes where I can just attach anything wherever I want with a simple adapter. Like right now I have a Titan NV6 on there and I have a Pinda probe over here. The Y carriage is just a flat FR4 sheet where I can just tap holes wherever I need them. Even the linear axes are built to be super simple and modular. And the other thing that this printer has is two power supplies, because I have plenty of 12 volt components, like, you know, basically everything on here, but also want to run, for example, the motor drivers at 24 volt and want to be able to test 24 volt parts in the future. And you can actually do the same for your printer in both directions. If you have a 12 volt system, you can run the motor drivers at 24 volts because they'll perform better. They have more voltage to work with, so they can push the motors harder, especially at higher speeds. But you can just as easily use a secondary 12 volt supply in a 24 volt printer if you're having trouble, for example, finding, you know, 24 volt fans and want to use cheaper 12 volt ones instead. Or even you can use 5 volt parts, that totally works as well. And you can also just add a second power supply of the same voltage. For example, if your mainboard has the capacity to run a new heated bed, but your old power supply isn't up for it. But you don't even have to use a full separate power supply if all you need is running parts of the wrong voltage and you're not trying to say, you know, run a heated bed, which I am trying to do here, from that secondary power supply. But if you're not, then you can just use one of these, you know, buck step down or boost converters to go from 24 to 12 or 5 volts. These are literally 30 cents. Link in the description below. You can get these in all sorts of different capacities. This is a 5 amp one. These are like 3 amps. All really cheap. So you can use these to drive, for example, just your motors. So with a separate DC-DC module, you may be tempted to just strap that into the output of the mainboard and then run your components from that. And that can work. But as soon as the board tries to regulate the output power, you're rapidly turning the entire converter on and off, several hundred times a second, and every time all the capacitors and components get hammered with first fully discharging and then getting that rapid rush in current again when it starts back up. It's just not particularly elegant. But what we can do instead is to directly supply our load with that secondary voltage. For that, we need to look at what the mainboard is actually doing. Now, you might think that when the board is turning on or off a component, excuse the wiring in here, please, it's actually applying and removing the supply voltage. That would be called high side switching, but that's not what's being done here. It's actually cheaper and simpler to switch the ground of the output than it is to switch the supply voltage, but the effect on the load is the same. You're cutting that circuit and it means no current will be able to flow through the output. This is called low side switching, and what this means in practice is that the output has its positive terminal basically connected straight to the power input on the mainboard, and it's the negative terminal that's doing the actual switching. So knowing that, we can just disconnect the positive side of the load and reconnect it to a different supply. So keeping the negative side of your load connected to the board, we can use a separate power supply or a DC-DC converter to supply voltage to the load instead. So let's go through how to wire these up. First, the separate power supply. Connect both power supplies to the mains. As usual, be careful here. Mains voltage is dangerous. Get a friend to help you out if you're not totally competent or comfortable doing this. Then connect the ground or negative output from both supplies together and run a separate wire for the positive output to your load. The negative side of your load is still going to the mainboard's negative output, and from there, the current will travel back to the new supply through the wiring you already have. Circuit complete. You can also add a fuse if you want to protect your mainboard. That totally makes sense, and fuses are way cheaper than buying a new board or spending the time to fix a blown one. Now, if you want to use a DC-DC buck or boost converter, the wiring looks much the same. A DC-DC converter will have its input and output negative side tied together internally anyway, so you only need to connect one of the two to ground, either anywhere on the mainboard if it's just a fan, or directly to the power supply, just not to the negative output on the board. Then, the positive input of the DC-DC converter goes to supply voltage. Here, you can use the output on the mainboard, and that's probably a good idea if there are fuses built into the board. Or you can also directly go to the input or to the power supply output and add a fuse there if you feel like it. Then, the output of the DC-DC goes to your load, and the load's negative terminal goes to the negative terminal of the mainboard's output. Same as before. And this goes for both buck or step-down converters that output a lower voltage, and for boost or step-up converters. The only difference is that while buck converters specify output current, boost converters are usually rated for input current. So if you want to run a 2-amp, 24-volt load in a 12-volt system, you actually need at the very least a 4-amp boost converter, since on the input it will be drawing 4 amps to get that same power. Or, in reality, close to 5 amps since the converters aren't perfectly efficient. So, if you want to run motor drivers at 24 volts in a 12 volt system, it's the same idea as before. You tie together ground and then supply the output voltage of the boost converter either to the motor driver input on the board if you have a separate input for the drivers, or if you have socketed drivers, you can also solder in the pin for the VMOT supply upside down and jump with the supply voltage directly into the driver. Though this should be a backup only solution since the mainboard usually has a bunch of capacitors that buffer the supply voltage for the drivers, and you're completely skipping those if you wire in the supply directly. Before you connect any load though, you should adjust the output voltage of that DC-DC module. Use a multimeter to check on the output here or grab a converter with a display. There's one more thing you should check for if you're wanting to run a 24-volt component or a 24-volt load in a 12-volt system, and that is that your board is actually rated for 24 volts, because the MOSFET on the board is having to block that full 24 volt when it's trying to switch the load off. So yeah, that's how to use components that need different voltages in the same system. Again, if it's just fans, it probably makes more sense to use just a simple, cheap converter than scavenging around for specific 24-volt fans, but of course you can also mix and match parts however you like now. All the stuff is linked below. Like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell, that's actually really important as Veritasium recently explained. And yeah, thanks for watching, see you in the next one.